Then the close proximity to Elstree as well, which would be great, wouldn't it?
Yeah, yeah, it's down the road from my house, mate.
Yeah.
They won't have to pay me for travel.
That's true. I mean, let's talk about the Panto. What does Panto mean to you?
For me, it's all about putting smiles on people's faces. I've said this is my fourth Panto that I'm doing, and every year for me it just gets better and better. And, you know, the Magic Beans guys obviously know what they're doing. It seems like a great cast of people. And I can't wait to go on that stage and, you know, and make people smile, you know, and they can go home and enjoy themselves and tell people to come and see it, because it is a great family show.
Yeah.
You know?
The cast
leave their troubles at home and come and watch it and enjoy it.
Yeah. I mean, I've met two of the cast before. I met the great Leslie Grantham, who I think we need to tell everybody is going to be wearing a dress this winter. This Christmas.
Oh, yeah, he's like his stepsister. Yeah, I'm looking forward to meeting him.
He is he's a really nice guy. I've had the pleasure. And, of course, you've got one of the most insane ladies I've ever met in my life, Jessette Amos.
Yes, I met her, obviously, on the press day.
Yeah.
She was there.
Yes.
Hilarious, and I can't wait.
She is one of the craziest ladies I've ever met in my life, and I met her about 3 years ago for the first time, and it was ever the first time we ever met, and I had an hour in her company, and it was the best time I've ever had. She is absolutely mad, she is.
Seems like a good egg, and I can't wait to get started.
She is great, yeah. Yeah. And acting or singing, I think you probably mentioned this, actually, which do you actually prefer? You prefer...
I love them both. I mean...
Yeah.
If I can do both, i.e. do a musical, then I'm in a good place.
Yeah.
If a good acting job comes up, it's real gritty, or it's a nice comedy part, I'd love to do it. I want to get my teeth into as many things as I can, because, as I said, life is not a dress rehearsal.
No, you've got one shot at it. I mean,
exactly.
On Christmas Day, you've got the day off. What are you going to be doing, apart from probably having a nervous breakdown?
I'm going to be probably up at about 5:30, because that's when my little one wakes up, opening presents. Probably, bless her, she won't have a clue what's going on. She'll just be playing with wrapping paper. And, just spend the day with the family, really. Yeah.
Is your little one all right now? Because you had a little bit of a drama a little while ago, didn't you?
Oh, yeah, no, she's actually
good.
Fine now.
Yeah, I won't. We won't dwell on that one.
Running around. Yeah, she's brilliant.
Yeah. So, obviously, you'll be having great fun with her. Would you, down the line about, so we say, perhaps next year, put the thing in, would you fancy directing a Panto as well?
I'm not in that. I think the answer to that is because I'm not that confident yet.
No?
If you ask me in maybe 5-10 years' time, maybe. At the moment, I'm just enjoying being on the other side of the camera, so to speak.
Yeah? I'll hold you to that. I'll give you a call in 5 years' time. And, I mean, obviously Christmas now. Christmas presents. Let's talk about Christmas presents. What's the best present you've ever had?
On Christmas or in general?
Well, just do Christmas and then do in general as well.
Let's do Christmas. I don't know. I don't really get that many presents, really, because it's all about the kids, isn't it?
I agree.
Do you know what, Terry? I don't actually know. The best present I've ever had is the birth of my daughter.
Fabulous.
That's a present, but it's a very expensive present.
Yeah, you'd be paying for the rest of your life, probably, I think.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, if you can't remember the best present, have you ever had a present you wish you'd never received? Christmas one, especially.
Yeah, of course, all them like dodgy Christmas jumpers that your nan gets.
Yeah.
And you get a fake smile on and go, oh, it's really nice, thank you.
About two sizes too big or two sizes too small.
Absolutely, mate.
You've got one of them as well. Yeah, I've got one as well. And what are you? This Christmas is coming up. Is there a gift you'd like to get this year?
Do you know what, mate? I've got my elf, and I'm happy, and I think that's the best gift that anyone can have. Really, you know, I mean, there's so many people out there that aren't fortunate as us.
No.
Families and stuff, and you know, living on the street. That really upsets me. Do you know what I mean? But I've got my health, and I'm really happy where I am at the moment. I'm in a good place, and I'm just really, really, I'm just buzzing, mate. I can't wait to get started with Panto, and I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah. Away from the music business and the acting and all that business, I know you're a busy man. What do you do to unwind apart from playing with your daughter?
I'm winning the football, so So I go to watch my beloved Spurs every other
day. Hey! So you're the other Spurs fan. I wonder where we were.
Are you Spurs?
I'm a Spurs fan. I've only met two. I've met three guys who claim to be Spurs fans. There's Dennis Greaves of Nine Below Zero, Jimmy Jones the comedian, it's yourself and me. So I think we're the only four people who actually say we are Spurs fans. I think the rest of them are embarrassed, but never mind. Well, we shouldn't be embarrassed. Why should we be embarrassed?
Nah, mate, I ain't embarrassed. I'm proud, mate.
Yeah, I'm proud. I've been a Tottenham fan since 1969, and I've. When I was a young lad, I chose Tottenham, and I've been a Tottenham fan ever since. So there we go.
Right.
So do you get? It. Yeah. I mean, is there anybody you'd like to work with or sing with?
I think my idol growing up, and I loved everything he did, and I just thought he was a fantastic artist, and I just can't wait to hear some new music from him.
Who was that again?
George Michael, mate.
George Michael. So you'd like to sing with George and that, would you?
I'd love to.
Yeah. Okay. A couple more things, and then we talk about. Well, let's talk about the panto. We've got the panto coming up, and then we say goodbye because I know you're a busy man, touring, you're getting yourself organised for Christmas. The show Cinderella. It's at the Grove Theatre in Dunstable.
It is definitely 11th of December 3rd, Jan.
Yeah, and you see, that's right. 11th. I'm coming along on the 12th. So, and it stars yourself. You're Prince Charming.
I'm a Prince Charming, first time ever, so I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, and you've got, we mentioned him earlier, we've got Dirty Den, Leslie Grantham dressed up in a dress.
Leslie Grantham, mate.
The soap man, legend.
The man's a legend
He is one of the funniest comic timing guys I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, and really? I can't wait, mate.
He is fabulous. I mean, you're going to love him, I'll tell you. He lives overseas a lot of the time now, as he'll probably explain to you. And he's one of the nicest guys. Forget about all the rubbish you've read about him and all that. I had him on the show a couple of years ago, and he was so, so nice, such a gentleman. And also on the show, on the show, you've got EastEnders Ben Mitchell, Joshua Pascoe, and I think this is his debut in panto. And also, we mentioned her a little while ago. We got Jacette Amos in the show. She's playing the fairy godmother.
She's amazing. I mean, she what a voice she's got. I can't wait to hear her every day, mate.
I mean, she's a voice coach and all sorts, and
I know.
I think she's worked with Little Minx and a few other bands and all that.
Yeah, she's brilliant. She's really, really heard her stuff on YouTube, and I've seen some clips from last year's panto.
Yeah,
I can't wait to hear her.
She is a thing. Well, I know you're busy. Let's one last question. I mean, we're talking about the panto. You see, 11th to the 3rd of January over in Dunstable. If you want tickets, the box office is 01582 602080. And now I'm asking a lot of my guests at Christmas, your favourite Christmas song.
Oh, mate.
Or two. Choose two.
What mood I'm in, man. No, I mean, you've got Chris Rea, Driving Home for Christmas.
Yeah.
Last Christmas, Wham.
Yeah.
I might go Merry Christmas, War is Over, John Lennon.
John Lennon. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, well, I'll play that for you as we say goodbye. Good luck with the show, and good luck with everything you do. I'll see you on the 12th of December.
Yeah, brilliant.
Thank you very much for your time today. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Bella.
Cheers, Anthony. Cheers, Ed. Bye.
So this is Christmas, and what have you done? Another year over, just begun. And so this is Christmas, I hope you have fun. The near and the dear ones, the old and the young, a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. So happy Christmas.
Well, that's John Lennon and Merry Christmas, War is Over, as requested by Antony Costa. Can we get time to play at least one more of his other songs? As is the last show before Christmas, let's do a roundup of all the pantos in the area, or most of them. Some of them I've seen, some of them I haven't. This one I've seen, Aladdin, runs right through till Sunday the 10th of January, starring Priscilla Presley as the Genie in the Lamp, along with Wayne Sleep, Gary Wilmer, and singer-songwriter and former A1 band member Ben Adams, and also a gentleman I had on the show, along with Wayne Sleep, Kevin O'Cran. He plays Wishy Washy, and it's a fabulous glitzy panto. Ben Adams is amazing, and so is Kevin O'Cran. Kevin is the fool. He is, well, if you're listening a couple of weeks ago, you'll know what he's like. Tickets you can get there by ringing the box office 0844 871 7652, or you can go online at atgtickets.com/Milton Keynes. Down the road at the Auburn Arena, I've heard about this one. Apparently I've been told this is a great show, selling out, so you need to get your tickets pretty quickly. It's Peter Pan at the Auburn Arena, runs through to the 3rd of January, starring Jake Wood, Max off EastEnders, and of course 2014 Strictly, along with Bob Golding. Anybody who knows Bob, he's as mad as a box of frogs. Box office there is 01727 844 88, and you get tickets online at www.auburn-arena.co.uk. Down the road at Radlett, and I've heard this one's selling really well as well. Snow White, he's on there. That's on till the 30th of December, so only a couple of days, just over a week's time. And that's a traditional panto with hilarious comedy, live music, and the box office at Radlett is 01923 859 291, and that's www.radlettcentre.co.uk. And over in Hartford, they've got Hansel and Gretel. That runs till Friday the 1st of January, and the theatre box office there and in Hartford is 01992 531 500, or you can book online at www.hartfordtheatre.com. A little bit further out, if you're out that way, Bishop Stortford. You've got Jack and the Beanstalk at the Stortford Theatre in the Rhodes Arts Complex. That's on till the 2nd of January. And the tickets are quite reasonable there, £12 to £19. You book online at the Rhodes, bishopstortford.org.uk, or you can call the box office 01279 710 200. And then one I went to see couple of weeks ago, last Saturday, Cinderella. That's on till the 3rd of January. It features Blues Antony Costa, who plays Prince Charming. Got Lucy Reed, she's Cinderella. Jesse Amos, Leslie Grantham as the one of the ugly sisters. That's worth the admission fee alone. And Joshua Pascoe, well, he's at the moment in a wheelchair. He was when I went to see it. He twisted his ankle on some high heels. We won't mention that. I didn't mention it last week, but I've just mentioned it. Box office here, 01582 602080, and you can book online at growthatre.co.uk.